who love disruption here? Okay, as a human, I believe no one loves disruptions. Grab, Uber, Airbnb, Netflix. What is a common between all these companies? You heard this company before, right? Yes, what is a common between them? They use a disruptive technology to conquer the market. Okay, Grab, for example, they use a smartphone application for the bookings. So when you use that smartphone application, you can compare to the conventional taxi system. What you have if you have a smartphone? You know the waiting times, you know the fare, you know where they are. So that is the disruptive technology that the Grab use. So we've seen the disruptive technology change the way we live, the way we do our jobs, okay? The effects, the way we communicate with each other, and also the way that how the community works.
Okay.
So we go to the definition of the disruptive technology. The disruptive technology actually refers to the new market, a new customer, and also take over the current established technology. What I can put in the simple terms is a new way of doing things. Okay, it's a new way of doing things. Disruptive technology has been around so many years ago. Okay, it has revolutionized so many areas. For example, finance, business, products, services, and even reshaped our societies. Either you like it or not, it's happening right now. So you cannot be it. You need to force to join them. That is disruptive technology. So we're into one of the story. Anybody use this phone? Now, I believe all of you use either iPhone or the Samsung, LG, Huawei. Okay. So let's take a look what happened to the BlackBerry phone. A long time ago, there was a phone called BlackBerry. This phone have a nice GUI, nice interface, with very good security, a nice application productivity. So what happened to them? So when they are not dominate the market at the time. So what happened when the iPhone and Androids come into the market, they bring the touchscreen technology. Okay? But the BlackBerry, they are concerned too much. They say they want to protect what they have. They say, I have a QWERTY keypad, I want to stick with the QWERTY keypad. The Android iPhone, they bring the touchscreen technology. They say, we don't want to explore a new thing. We want to stick with the keypad. So what happened to them? So the iPhone and the smartphone technology, the Android, they take over the current market with the touchscreen technology. While the BlackBerry, who stick with the QWERTY keypad, fall behind and lost the market share. So this is what happened to the BlackBerry. So what we can learn from here? So, as for you, know how good you are. No matter how good you are, there's always a potential to do better. Okay, don't stop there. But, so if you are not willing to do it, somebody else will. Okay, if you don't want to do it, somebody else will come and do it. Okay? So embrace or you will be instinct. So when disruptive technology introduced to the market, it brings a good and a bad impact to the society. So I would like to highlight three examples here. The one is IKEA, the second is MOOC, and the third one is of course is WhatsApp. So for the first one, IKEA. So what is a good and a bad thing about the IKEA? So have you assembled the product for IKEA before? Yes. Okay, so IKEA is a product. You need to assemble the product by yourself. You need to spend time, you need to put your strength into the product. Why don't you just go to the furniture shop, buy the exact way? Why do you want to spend more time and strength to put all together? Because what the IKEA offer is something that you cannot buy, which is experience. Experience to put everything by yourself. It give you, they sell you, it not just sell you the furniture, they sell you experience. They sell you the confidence, so you feel empowered. Okay, this is how the IKEA business model. The second one is a MOOC. I believe as a student, you heard about this before, right? Yes, it's an open, massive open online courses where actually you can learn everything through internet. So what happened with the MOOC? So as a student, I know you have a money to pay your tuition fee, right? But what happened to the people who don't have money? It's a poor family who don't have money. So how they can learn about the education? So the MOOC actually offer education for those who don't have money. You can learn everything through the internet. But the bad thing about the MOOC is you lack of the chemistry. You didn't see the face physical contact. You lost it. Even they give you an advantage, but they give you some bad effects as well. And the third one, I believe all of you here use a WhatsApp application, right? So what's the good thing about WhatsApp? It's a free, right? You can just send the SMS, nothing know about how much they sell to you. Then you say, we just send everything. You can send the picture, you can send the document. So no need to pay anything. So what happened to this WhatsApp? The back impact of it. So no one used the SMS, right? Have you heard about the SMS? No. So you not use the SMS, right? So you less people use the SMS. So what happened to the SMS? So it bring a lot of losses to the company, especially to the telco company. They lost millions of dollars because no one used the SMS. So you are depending on the WhatsApp. So what we can learn here is when the disruptive technology is introduced, there always one party is winning and the others is losing. Okay, that's why we call it disruptive technology. And why it happened? There are three major reasons why disruptive technology happened. The first one, of course, is because of the smartphone user. So I believe you know you have the smartphone right now, right? You have a computer. But do you believe that people in the rural area, they don't have the computer? So the first time they access the internet, just using the smartphone. They didn't know about the computer. They know about the smartphone first. Compared to you all guys here, you know the computer first, right? So you see the people start knowing about technology not because of the computer. It's because they have smartphone. So the numbers of the smartphone increase year by year. And now it's almost at 3 billion right now. And the second is about the Industrial Revolution 4.0. So you know about this technology, right? It's a new emerging technology, consists of the cloud, Internet of Things, virtual reality, robotics, AI. So all this new technology actually is branded under the name Industrial Revolution 4.0. So if you are working on the new technology, you are based on this new emerging technology. And the third one is about product recycle. So I believe all of you here have a TV at home, right? Okay. So long time ago, have you seen the CRT TV? The big one? Right. Okay, how long it lasts? 3, 4, 10 years, right? But nowadays, you see that the TV, it keep replacing each year. Well, you see, now they have an LCD TV. The next year, they come with the LED. The next one, they come with the 4K TV. You see the technology coming in very, very fast compared to from the past few years, decades ago. So the new product coming in very fast. Even the new product is still at the growing and maturity, a new product coming in and replace it compared to the few years ago. So all these reasons because of the disruptive technology. So have you asked yourself what you want to be in the next few years? Okay. So, what you will become in the next few years as a student? So, there is three questions, okay, you need to ask yourself if you want to participate in disruptive technology. The first one is, do you have a knowledge to do it or not? Okay, the first thing is about knowledge, your internal factor, the most important. Okay. The second one, do you have resources or not? The resources means you have money or not. Do you have a team to do it or not? You cannot work alone, right? You need a team. So this is your resources. And the third one, you need to ask yourself, do you have a timeline or roadmap to do it or not? I mean, in a way to achieve your objective, you must have a timeline. You cannot just say, oh, I'm going to over there, I'm going there. You need to have a timeline. So this timeline actually guided you towards your objective. So this KRT, I call it KRT, eh? Knowledge, resources, and the timeline is three important if you want to involve in the disruptive technology. So in a way to map it, I want to use my own story. So this is how I get here from my degrees, and I come here as a senior lecturer. So let's take a look what happened to me. So I graduated from the UTM in 2004. Then later, instead of joining academy, actually I joined the industry first. So in 2004, just after I graduated, I joined HP as a procurement engineer. Then later in 2006, so I become a tutor and a lecturer at University of Malaysia Pahang. So why I from the industry, I joined the academy after that? So I will share that story later. And then later, after I working at the UMP, I continue my study at Loughborough University in UK for my PhD. Then later I come back here 2016, become a senior lecturer. And this is what I want to tell you about. So how I become a person who involved in disruptive technology. So in 2016, I joined a business competition called Super. So this business competition actually offer you ₱500,000 for you to start up your business. So I, from academic life, I say I want to join the business. So I go pitch my idea over there. So I won that competition. So now actually I'm ₱500,000 richer. So later, I've been given opportunity to open up my own company. So the company called Venigo Stream, right? So this company actually involved on one of the disruptive product called a vein finder. Have you seen vein finder before? It's an imaging product where you can see the vein throughout the naked eyes. So if you want to have a needle prick into your blood, so normally doctor will step into your hand, right? So we develop a product where we can see the vein without tapping anything. You just turn on and you can see the blood straight away. So this is my company work on it. So we currently assemble that product right now. So what I'm targeting this year is to soft launch this product. So in the business side. So at the side as academy, I'm targeting to get the chartered engineer and professional engineer I have as well. So this is my story. So how actually I want to map into the KRT, knowledge, resources, and the timeline. So this is how I map it. So you can see from my timeline, this is all the knowledge that I get. You can see it's across all the time. So what you can learn from it? Don't stop, look for the knowledge. Okay, don't stop for knowledge. Even you are working after this, don't stop looking for the knowledge. Eh? Always go for it. Because the knowledge actually is the essence of your intelligence. Then there are three resources, place where I want to highlight to you. One, when I'm working as a procurement engineer, the resource that I get actually is from my own money. So in order to work with disruptive technology, I use my personal money to work on that. This is one of my resources. The second is when I pitch my idea to get the ₱500,000. This is the second resource I have. And the third one, when I have a company, I use that company to get the investor from the outside. So this is the third way to get all the resources. So the first one, you can use your own pocket money. The second is because you can get from any competition, any grants from the outside. And the third one, you look for the investor out there. So there are a lot of people willing to get your product. So the timeline here is very important. So you can see the timeline actually is lock everything together. Okay? So to meet your objective, you must have a strong timeline. So it bound your resources, your knowledge, everything all together. So I would like to share you with the story about the egg. Okay, so have you seen the story about the egg before? This is not about who come first or come later. Okay, this is a different story about the egg. Okay, so if you can see the egg on the left, you can see there's a pressure applied to the egg. Okay, then what happened? If nothing, it just cracked like that, it become the plain egg. So on the egg on the right side, they have a different scenario. They have a similar pressure applying to the egg, but there's a different case here. There are something from the inside to repair it. Okay, so it become a new life. There are two different scenario. When you are seeing any pressure, anything happening around you, if you done nothing, you become the egg of the at the left. So if you do something from the inside, you become an egg. It's a new life. So what I can say, I want to project this into my reality. So in my early days, I didn't do anything. I see anything around me change. A new technology, a new initiative, new thing to explore. But as a me, I'm afraid to do things. I'm afraid because I don't have money. Because I'm afraid that I will fail. Okay? If you fail, people will laugh at you. Right? Okay, that's why what happened to me. But I said to myself, will I become the observer? Means I see everything doing nothing. Or I want to participate in the disruptive technology. So if I participate, then I will become a new life. Okay, just like the right thing. So what I can tell to you, so all of you are important here. Okay, you have a chance to do things, many things around you. Because either you have a courage to do it, or you just become just an observer. Okay, you just see anything, don't want to take action of it. I see all of you have a different background, but you have something in common. What is it? All of you have a something in common. That's your face. It's a face of the future. Okay, thank you.